Dear students, we have formally started working in Microsoft Access, and we have already imported some of the data which was available in Microsoft Excel into Microsoft Access in the previous module. And in this module, we are going to start another topic in this series of topics on Microsoft Access. That is known as that how we can create tables and how we can manage tables in database. So we will try to cover how tables can be created, how we can add fields, how data can be added, and how we can update and delete the records and even the tables. So let's start the practical. So this is the Microsoft Access environment, and in this environment we have started to use the previous file which was already opened in the previous module. And this file has already a table of 220, which was extracted in the last module, and then it has also the student table. So just let's make another table, a new table. So for example, you go into create and then you click on table. So this at the moment is known as table one. So let's try to save it first so that the name of the table can be saved. So for example, we want to put the name of the table as course. So this is a course table. So tables mean one logical related record, set of records. So for example, student will have one table. So all of the information related to student will be stored in student table. So all of the information related to courses will be stored in the courses table. And you will also learn that how we try to make tables in database management system course in next semesters. So at the moment, we are not interested in how you make a database and how you get to know that which table can be created and which table will have which fields. So at the moment, we are making things very simple, that any information related to student will be stored in student table, and any information related to course will be stored in the course table. So how we will further define the course table? So you need to click on it, and then on the right click, you can go into design view. So the design view would be somewhere area in which you can design that how many fields will be there in this course table. And then you can also do the same thing by clicking on course, go on to create, and then you can click on design. So whatever way you follow, so for example, we follow this way. So here we have the course, and the first field is ID, and that has different types. So for example, we are interested to store one course ID, and that course ID would be of data type number, text, date, time, currency, auto number, or some other field. So our course ID would be of number. So number means that only the numbers can be stored in this course ID. For example, if our course code is 101, so that is perfectly fine, we can store it as number. However, if our course code is CS101, or we want to store CS101, then that CS101 cannot be stored in number, then we need text, because CS is not the characters which form a number. So at the moment, try to stick on number. Then we have course name. So course name would be text, and then for example, credit hours, and that credit hours would be text, number. It would be number, right? And as soon as you click on save, this data is being, this table definition has been finished, and you can go into the courses by double clicking on it. And then you can see that this table is asking us to fill the values. So for example, we are interested to say we are saving 101, that is ITC, credit hours are 4, for example. Then 102, another field is added. So I'm just focusing a particular field and entering the data. So for example, that is physics, and that has 3 credit hours. 103, that is, for example, English, that has 3 credit hours. Then 104, calculus, and that has 3 credit hours. So whenever you have entered the data, you need to click on save. So this data has been stored. So for example, if you go to the other table and then you come back to the main table, so you can see that these 4 records are already have been stored. So we have created a table, we have added the fields, and we have added the data. Now if you want to delete any record from this table, so you just need to focus that record and then you can just delete it. So for example, let's move to the deletion process. So for example, here we want to delete this record. So it's asking, you are about to delete one record, which was, it was 102. It has already deleted and it is showing, but if we select no, it will be reverted. So we are interested to delete physics, and we said okay, delete record, and that 102 has been deleted. And once it's deleted, you need to click on save. So this is how the values in this table are filled and how the field is deleted. And then if you are interested to update, so for example, now we are interested to say that this is not calculus, this is calculus 1. So you can just add dash 1, come over here again, 1. So calculus 1 is added over here, and once it is added, so press on save. So this save will save these changes. So this is how the data would be updated. So if you go to the student and then come back, so you can see that this has been updated. So we have seen that how the table is generated, how the records are added, how the records are deleted, and how the record is updated. So one important thing for any table is that it should have a primary key. So here you can see a key. So this means that all of the information present in this table, any of the record will be uniquely identified using course ID. This means that there could be no 2 courses having the same code. So if that is the case, then it's not the primary key. So for example, if we do like this, so it says the changes requested to the table were not successful because they would create duplicate values in the index, primary key, or relationship. Change the data in the field or fields that contain duplicate values, remove the index, or redefine the index to permit duplicate entries, and try again. So it is not giving us a chance to make it the same. So this means that we even cannot forcefully enter any of the values which are duplicated in this table on course ID field. So any field in the table should be a primary key. And then there was another thing which I want to show. If I go on student table and design view, and then it's saying auto number. So this auto number means that it will add primary key automatically. So whenever I enter record number 1, so it will give it the ID 1. Then when I will enter the record number 2, it will give it the ID 2. So for example, if I just say student name, and that would be text, okay, and save, and try to enter the record. So for example, if I say Ali, so you have seen that I have not entered 1. It has automatically added 1 in the first record. And if I say Akbar, so it has added 2 automatically in the ID field. So this is called auto increment. So we are not focusing to make all of the records as uniquely identified by ID. So it is being maintained by the MS Access by itself. So let's conclude today's module. We have learned today many things by making how we can make new tables, how we can add record, how can we delete record, how can we update record, and we have seen that how different types of data can be stored, like text, number, auto number, etc. And we will be coming back to you with some other exciting features of Microsoft Access in the next module.